In this video, we will walk through the steps to enable Rebus devices through the inverter screen. If the inverter has been enabled, please disable it before touching the DC disconnects. Also, if this is a multi-inverter system, follow the process spelled out in the Generac Power Cell Inverter Installation Manual, or call our tech support before continuing. After the DC disconnects are switched on, we can enable the inverter. Press the right button to access the inverter device page, then select the center button. Grid connected will be displayed on the inverter device page. Now that the system is grid connected, Rebus voltage is present at each device. We can see each connected and disabled device on its respective device page. Use the right and left buttons to scroll through device pages, the center button to enter the device page settings, and the left button to exit the device page. In each device menu page, make note of the RCP number, or RCPN. We can record the unique last 5 digits for each device. This is especially helpful for the PV links to confirm they match with the values collected from the array sitemap. For systems without SnapRS devices in the power zone, press the center button and select Enable. More commonly, for systems with SnapRS installed, select Enable with PVRSS. The PV link tests its substring and counts the SnapRS devices. This test can take up to 60 seconds per PV link. When complete, it will display Making Power. If you see a different message, reference the Generac PV link and SnapRS manuals. For these additional scenarios, guidance is also found in the manual. Repeat this process for each PV link. For each battery, select Enable. Once they perform their initial test, they will either be in standby, charging, or discharging state. The last device on the screen will be Rebus Beacon Time of Use, or TOU scheduler. Do not enable this device unless you need a time of use schedule. Scroll to the right to return to the home screen where we can verify system production. You may also set the system mode now. For systems without a battery, we recommend grid tie. For systems with a battery, we recommend clean backup. See the Generac Power Cell Inverter Owner's Manual for more information on system mode options. See the links in the video description below to access more video resources and to enroll in the PowerCell Sales and Installation course. Completing the course will give dealers access to claim warranty compensation, as well as advanced technical support.